digital imaging experts who represent both sides of this controversy. Jim Delatoso, the president of Village Labs in Tempe, Arizona, and Cal Korf, president of Total Research in San Jose, California, have both analyzed the Meier photos and footage. Their conclusions could not be more different.
When I first saw the Meier photographs, I thought it was a product of the special effects team. The Meier photographs were beautiful. The ships were totally in focus, up close, and I was amazed. I'd never seen anything like that before.
The computer shows under color edge enhancement processing this supportive line above the image here, and you can see a second one above this other object here. And in five other photos that we have examined from the sequence, for a total of six separate pictures, we have found supportive structures.
The entire focus of what's going on with extraterrestrials lives in the Meier case. Some of it looks suspicious. Some of it looks like it couldn't possibly be real. Some of it is real.
Jim Delatoso is an individual who is not qualified professionally or personally to render the verdicts, if you will, that he does on various UFO photographs. We have caught Delatoso lying repeatedly about his background, and Jim Delatoso's conclusions can never be replicated by anybody else except Jim Delatoso.
Disturbs me when he claims that I'm involved with a hoax, perpetrating a fraud, that we don't know what we're doing, that I'm getting rich off of it, because that's not what's true. And that's not what I'm about. So when I read these things, I don't like it.
Joining us in studio are Jim Delatoso and Cal Korf. Jim's among the staunchest supporters of the Meier evidence. Now Cal Korf feels quite differently. Cal believes that the Meier footage is simply not credible. Cal, why do you feel that way?
Well, I've been to Switzerland, unlike Mr. Delatoso, and I've examined the evidence firsthand. When you go to the actual locations where the images were taken, it is not possible for them to be framed or filmed the way that Billy Meier claims, and anyone can go there and independently check that themselves.
Now, Jim, you've come up with some very different conclusions.
Yes. Well, I don't agree with the fact that they can't be framed that way. What we've done is put together a team of experts going back over 15 years to examine the photographs, the hard evidence, and come up with the opinion based on scientific examination that these are real pictures.
This is a picture of Billy in a suit. He's on a prehistoric planet to see the dinosaurs. He's got a breathing apparatus on. This is a Pleiadian man, and they've stepped outside of the ship so he can see the animal life on this prehistoric world. Here's the dinosaur pictures. Billy's back inside the ship, and there's a viewing screen in the craft, and he says he's taking these pictures. Here's our first dino. He's got kind of gold-brown skin, got large hind legs, short forelegs, and a head that looks kind of amphibian, like a vegetarian type. Here's the second one. There's a bird here apparently dropping some food or something. Here he's on board one of their large motherships. This is the side or the edge of a saucer that was parked inside as he was walking by it. Here's Jupiter. Here's the mothership in orbit. They're flying into it to go aboard. It was 17 miles high and about 10 miles in diameter. He spent 3 days on it. They went to different places in our galaxy to show him around. This was the craft that was right in front of him as they were flying into it.
Been in the ship, why not photographs inside of the Pleiadians themselves?
It's impossible to make it because there are powers inside, they always break the film.
He's taken a number of rolls of film, and when they're developed, they're usually black. If they've got anything, it's wavy lines through.
So you're so talking
lose it, so 100 of film.
Now, faking a still photograph is one thing, but Cal, how do you explain this moving footage?
Well, the first problem is that I find it very strange in this movie that the camera never moves. Now, what are the odds of positioning your camera and having a UFO fly about? Why isn't Meier following the object? The reason he isn't following the object is because he's busy moving the model around. Secondly, this tree is the same tree that appears in the Fuchsbuhl sequence that later conveniently disappeared. Thank you. The owners of this house back here, which is a Japanese family, have testified that there's never been a tree at this location. We were at these locations, and no one in the area said that they ever saw a tree there. I even saw photos and family albums of the Swiss families who live there taken of their kids over the years, and they show no tree there.
Are you saying that someone took a tree and placed it in that position?
It's a technique called forced perspective. Hollywood has been using it for nearly 100 years. I'm not the only one to come up with this conclusion.
This is the location of the 1975 photo. As you can see, there is no tree. No one seems to remember where the film was taken, but it was not taken in either Wetzikon or in Pinwell. So all of the evidence suggests that this same model tree was used in the different photographs and films because the trees all share the same physical characteristics. The tree is the same size and shape even after 6 years. The photos and films were each taken in different cities. There's no evidence that a real live tree ever existed in any of these locations. And the official explanation from Meier and his followers is that the extraterrestrials erased people's memories about the tree, but they left the photographs and the films alone.
It's said that the tree was eliminated later by Semjase. Strangely enough, the farmer who owns the land continues to this day to mow the grass around the very spot where the tree once existed. This panoramic photo composite was actually provided by Figu. What the skeptic failed to show or acknowledge is that Figu also provided this panoramic view overlaid with one of Meier's many photos of the UFO circling the full-size tree. As you can see, the photo fits in perfectly, validating that both the tree and the UFO were indeed on that very piece of land. Actually, Meier took photos of UFOs next to different kinds of trees, including these barren branch trees, four of them in this photograph. He took photos of the UFOs above trees and even in forests. Professional photographer, model maker, and miniature tree cultivator Jeff Ritzman tried to duplicate Meier's UFO tree photos and couldn't. And on top of that, six professors of forestry looked at Meier's photos and looked at the trees, and each one determined that the trees are full-sized, mature trees and not models.
Jim, you had a point to make?
He's claiming the use of forced perspective in trick photography, and that is not the case. This is not scientific. This is an attempt to prove that the case is wrong in order to sell a book. This is wrong in UFO investigations, that a group of people who scientifically go out to analyze and to test things can be just set aside because one person claims that there is a they, that there is a group, and that they are using testing procedures that have all the right words, but it is not scientific, and he knows it.
That's not true. Let me tell you what my position is, because I'm the only one who can state it. I'm a UFO researcher first and foremost. I'm after the truth. I don't care what that truth is. When I study a UFO case, I go in there without...
How many other cases have you studied?
Thousands, Jim.
Which are they? You have not published one thing.
I've had over 90 articles
on other
published.
UFO cases.
That is not true. I can send you... I have tons of newspaper clippings over the year. The producers have those here.
I just don't understand. What do you think the motivation would be for someone like a Billy Meier to create such an elaborate hoax, as you say it is? Why?
I do not address motivation in any of my work because there's no way to scientifically test for it. All I do is say, of all the evidence they offer, This is how it seems to stand up. This is how it seems not to stand up. Why Billy Meier does what he does, I don't know. I can't speak for him. Only he can.
Looks like we're at the beginning of many more shows about this subject. Thank you both for being with us.
You're welcome.